First, what actions have you taken coming from the President's State of the Nation address that there are no obstructions on the roads?
Actually, even prior to the son of the president, I issued Executive Order Number 4, removing the street parking in areas of Barangay Greenhills, specifically Club Filipino Avenue,
yes,
Annapolis,
yeah,
Missouri, and Connecticut. This is the perimeter of the Greenhills Shopping Center, wherein motorists are subjected to the worst traffic in the entire city every single day for the last how many years? So we issued this executive order last week, and it was implemented yesterday. Day one was yesterday because we gave establishments a 1 week notice.
Okay.
That's why during the president's sauna last Monday.
This must be new, no? Because it's so clean now.
Yes, that was effective yesterday. The EO has been implemented, and we noticed that the roads have become so clean, and traffic has been flowing properly. And during the son of the president, I was happy when he mentioned this because obviously it was something that we wanted to do.
Uh-oh.
And last Monday I heard from himself that it's something that he wanted us mayors to do. So it was in conjunction with
this. Just to clarify, those that go to the Greenhills shopping area, I mean, I'm quite familiar.
Yes.
So you, what street is that? One, Annapolis, and then may Connecticut ba?
Yes, Club Filipino. So if you're coming from Ortigas Avenue, you enter through Club Filipino Drive.
Okay.
Which will lead you to Club Filipino, and then you turn right to Annapolis where
Pero
you will
yung
hit
buong Club Filipino Drive, bawal na ngayon.
Yes, left and right.
Yes, left and right.
Yes, and then turn right to Annapolis, where OB Montessori is, the stretch of Annapolis. So to the right, where street parking was allowed before, it's cleared already now. Then you turn right to Missouri along Promenade, that will lead you towards Connecticut. Both sides are also cleared. Then when you turn right to Connecticut all the way to Ortigas, both sides are cleared also.
So ang tanong ngayon, where will they park?
The Greenhills Shopping Center currently has close to 4,000 parking slots.
Yeah.
They have 8 parking buildings, and by the end of the year, they will be having close to 5,000 parking slots.
So in other words, if you want to bring your car to Greenhills, pay for your parking.
No, because before, the city government used to charge street parking.
I see.
Yes, it was not free. So, but the problem there was, they were parking on the road.
Yeah.
The streets of San Juan are very small. Even the streets of Greenhills are small.
Yeah.
And they only have 2 lanes. The previous administration allowed street parking in half of the road. So you only have 1 lane left for the cars to pass.
Now that's the Greenhills shopping area.
Yes.
But what will you do in other parts of San Juan? The smaller roads, I mean, where you have houses, small stores and shops that when you pass, alam mo naman, nasa kalye rin yung kotse.
Yes, correct. No, we started with the Greenhills Shopping Center first because this is our main commercial area. And now we will move towards entering the inner roads in all the barangays.
Okay. You've also unlocked gated communities for traffic during rush hours.
No, not yet.
Not yet, okay.
There's a proposal to do that. Now, if there will be a directive from the president or from the DALG, then we will have to follow.
But do you have the power to do that? Because you do have, I mean, exclusive subdivisions in Greenhills.
Yes. We will have to closely coordinate with the village associations.
Uh-oh.
In fact, even in previous years, this proposal has already cropped up.
But now, since I were to ask you, what would you want?
Well, if there will be certain windows that will be asked of the associations, and if the president himself will really push for it and the DALG will push for it, then we have to comply. If you listen to DALG Secretary Anyo, he is giving us 60 days to clear all road obstructions, sidewalks, or else we will be suspended.
Okay.
So
all right.
I have to do my job.
Yes. Now, you've been mayor now for 26 days.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Exactly, yes, correct.
26 days. And you've discovered so far that San Juan has a debt of 1.3 billion pesos. I want you to explain that first.
Okay.
The debt itself.
Okay.
What's the budget of San Juan again?
Okay, 2.5 billion pesos is our budget. Now,
That's quite small, no?
We're small. We're a small city.
Okay.
So if you analyze per capita,
You're okay.
We're okay. Yes. However, the city government loaned 720 million for the construction of our new City Hall.
Yes.
Well, it's not that new anymore. That was way back in 2012.
Yeah.
And then just last year, they loaned another 500 million pesos for the renovation of the San Juan Medical Center and the procurement of equipment. So that would total around 1.2 billion.
But let's start first with this. So it's 2012, the loan is 1.3. 731 million was spent for the new City Hall.
Yes.
Okay. But then, is there anything irregular about that?
Looking at the papers that were turned over to us, I'm actually holding to the report of the Finance Committee. The construction of the City Hall was 520 million pesos. But we saw that there was a variation order or a variance of 167 million pesos. Under the law, you're only allowed 10% for variance or only 52
million. So technically,
million.
Dapat mga 52 million lang ang ginastos ng San Juan
for the variation.
For the variation.
Yes. And then furnitures and fixtures, 43 million pesos or a total of 731 million pesos to be exact. So that was the total expense for the City Hall. And we have to pay all the way until January 2025.
For the City Hall.
That's 9.9 million pesos every quarter until 2025, just for the City Hall.
But let's start first with this. You are you planning to file cases against former Mayor Gia Gomez, or are you going the Isko Moreno route also, wherein ayoko, I don't want to have anything to do with filing cases?
No, we have already asked the Commission on Audit to audit the finances of San Juan. This is not because we are retaliating or because of vengeance. This is because we want to be transparent with our people. Mm-mm. I want people to know how much we really have. Because 1.3.
So I'm curious, how much do you really have? Like today, how much does San Juan have?
1.3 billion pesos was turned over to us through a check.
Okay.
Before my term started. But after 1 week of review, we noticed and we found out that here, my details here. We had, as of June 30, cash on hand of around 1.3 billion pesos.
Someone might say that's not too bad.
Yes, but if you look at the other items here, you have a trust fund, Barangay Special Education Fund.
Of close to 300 million,
which we cannot touch because these are already allocated.
Yes.
We have long-term payables of 44 million pesos. So this brings our general fund to around 1 billion pesos. However, please take note that the payables for 2019 are already in the amount of 650 million pesos, which will give you around 350 million pesos left. But the projected income of San Juan is around 700 million pesos. That means you'll have around 1 billion pesos left. However, the projected expenses based on the 2019 executive budget, which the previous administration passed, points to the fact that we will spend around 1 billion pesos. So we will end the year with a deficit of around 100 million pesos.
And what will you do with that? How do you intend to solve that?
Okay, before I answer that question, I'd like to share to you that the Commission on Audit released a report 2 weeks ago stating that based on their audit, not ours, their audit, 736 million pesos of uncollected taxes was discovered by the COA.
Yeah.
This is uncollected business taxes.
I wanted to ask you this because, yes, the Commission on Audit said that in 2017 and 18, they named 8 of the biggest businesses in San Juan as not paying the right taxes. So they actually named them as Pure Gold Price Club, Ortigas and Company Limited, Motor Image Filipinas, Motor Image Manila, Tektron, Colinas, Hospital Managers Corp, which actually is Cardinal Santos, Unimart, and Integrated Computer Systems. My question now is, what will you do?
Okay, first of all, the Business Permits and Licensing Head has already resigned. He resigned a few days into our term. So it's funny because he resigned a few days before this COA report
came out.
So what I did is I put in an OIC, BPLO head, and my orders to the entire city government is to make tax collection more efficient.
Yeah.
We will not raise the percentage of taxes. However, we will make it more efficient. Business taxes and real property taxes.
Uh-oh.
Because given that COA report, we are losing a lot of money.
Oh, but how do you intend to address these 8 big companies?
Okay, we will have to review all their papers because this COA report based it on the SEC submission of these reports versus what was paid to the city government.
Uh-oh. So could the COA report in terms of tax collection be inaccurate or not up to date?
It will depend on how the COA performed their audit. However, whatever papers were submitted to us, we will now audit also ourselves.
But
then
has your office,
how big the discrepancy
but
will
has
be.
Your office reached out to these companies?
Yes,
already?
We've already coordinated with them. In fact, since I put in a new business permit and licensing head, we are already in coordination with these companies.
Uh-oh.
And they have committed to cooperate with us.
Okay. Well, according to the COA report, this is not ours, is of the 8 businesses, the COA claims Pure Gold Price Club registered the highest under-collected taxes of $625 million.
Yes. So we have to review if indeed this is just the San Juan branch or possibly other branches. But we are basing it on the COA report that was given to us. In fact, I'm already scheduling a meeting with the Chairman Aguinaldo of the Commission on Audit to discuss this and, among other things, of course, to discuss the finances of San Juan. So we want to get a more detailed report in connection with this COA findings. And from there, we can now deal with the 8 companies because whatever was submitted to the San Juan City government is different from what is submitted in the SEC. So these have to be reconciled.
Okay, you said the person in charge or the official in charge of tax collection resigned.
Yes.
Actually, before the COA report came out. Do you suspect, do you suspect some kind of tolerance? Because for 2 years, this was 2 years of under-collection.
Yes. Well, I'm very saddened by the fact that our collection is very low. So not just in business permits, but also in real property taxes. So I know that if we have efficient tax collection, we can indeed raise the income of the city of San Juan without necessarily increasing the percentage of taxes.
Without raising new taxes?
No, we will not raise new taxes. However, I commit to a more efficient tax collection process in San Juan.
So will they see that the first year of your term?
Yes, we are anticipating a 30% increase in our tax collection without necessarily increasing the percentage. It is just making sure that establishments pay the right taxes. It is making sure that real property owners pay the right taxes because now we are seeing that there is a lot of deficiency in the manner that these taxes have been collected.
Okay. You said that the last administration loaned 500 million pesos, but they built the San Juan Medical Center. During the campaign, you criticized that the hospitals in San Juan, well, specifically San Juan Medical Center, had no equipment.
Yes.
No medicine.
Actually, the 500 million pesos is a loan for the renovation and procurement of equipment. There has been an existing San Juan Medical Center, which was built in the start of around the year 2000, or probably a few years before that. Now, the city government, administration loaned 500 million pesos to renovate and rehabilitate this and procure. However, upon review, I was there last week. I again went around the entire hospital. It has remained to be unfinished. It is uncompleted. If you look at the front, yes, it looks complete. But as you enter and move towards the inside, you will see that there's a lot of unfinished work.
So where did the 500 million go?
That is where our audit will come in also. I have now assigned a team to audit the San Juan Medical Center. When we did the ocular last week, we noticed that a lot of the equipment that were delivered are still in crates. They are still unused. And because how can they be used? The hospital is not even fully operational yet. So that is...
So it's not operational now?
Not fully operational. So the original hospital, which is still in the back, is operating. But the front portion, which is part of the rehabilitation, is not yet operational.
Okay.
When you go to the other floors, it's not even completed yet. However, they're already trying to collect the payment for this, for the construction of the hospital. In fact, the equipment that were delivered, they're already fully paid, even if they have not been fully inspected, even if they're not yet fully operational. So that is, again, against COA rules, when you should only pay for this equipment once they have been tested.
I'm curious, were you able to speak with a transition team, at least, of Mayor Gia Gomez, so they could explain to you, did that happen? Did you have a proper transition?
Yes, documents and contracts were turned over to us. We had a transition team, and they also had theirs. But papers were simply turned over to us. So it was really up to us to review. And we had to do our due diligence. That's why, like what I was telling you before the show started, every day we are discovering something new in San Juan. And it is my duty to really check on all of this.
Could it be possible that Mayor Gia Gomez did not know some of the things happening below her? For example, this under collection of pure gold, allegedly, that is pegged at 625 million by COA. Could it be possible that the mayor's office did not know what the deputies may have been doing or not doing?
Karen, I don't want to speculate on that. But one thing is for sure, they received the report. And they are aware that there's indeed under collection in terms of taxes.
No. Okay, now moving on to another topic, the Zamora Ejercito war or battle. I mean, it's taken a toll on the city. And the biggest example, I was quite surprised that the West Crame Elementary School, which was actually built sometime in, was it 2013 or 15? 2015.
It was started in late 2014 and completed on December 8, 2015. So in the last 3 years and 8 months, this school has already been erected and waiting to be utilized. But good news, because it's going
to
open
already. Yeah, let's go back to that, because this is where I feel the Filipino people are cheated. Yes. When you have warring families in a city, imagine the city spent $38.8 million for that school. It can seat 600 students, and yet for 3 years, it was not open. I want to know why first.
Okay, just to give you a background, prior to our breakup, use that term.
But when this was finished, you were vice mayor?
Yes, I was vice mayor. My father was congressman. This is actually
coming from USPDAF,
Funded through the national government.
Okay.
So being the congressman, he was able to put it in the national budget for 2015. The day we had our groundbreaking in 2014, we were still all together and we were still allies. In fact, the former mayor was with us, and we even had a nice groundbreaking ceremony where everybody was happy. After the breakup, sometime June 2015, things changed. So when the building was completed December 8, 2015, yes, we inaugurated it, but it was never allowed by the city government to open. Allegedly, bullets would come out of the firing range of Camp Crame, and this was used as a reason not to open the school. And the city government, through the city council, was trying to change the utilization of the school to either a drug rehabilitation center or a housing project, which my dad cautioned them and told them, if they do that, they're liable for criminal charges, because under the GAA, this was indeed intended for a school.
Yeah.
But Karen, look at it this way. If bullets really come out of the firing range,
why would you have a drug rehab there? Still
or
people
or a housing project.
Yeah.
You should, if indeed bullets come out of that firing range, you should already clear that entire road and declare it as a danger zone. Because
and in the 3 years, they never did.
They never
touched it. So
they never did.
Technically, what's sad, it was a white elephant in San Juan.
Na politika.
It was sitting there for 4 years.
3 years and 8 months to be exact.
Unused,
because they were claiming that it was unsafe. In 2017, we continued to fight for the utilization of the school. Then PNP Chief General Bato and the Secretary Briones of DepEd issued a certification that indeed the school was safe for use. That's why during the entire campaign, 2016 and 2019, I was promising Barangay Waskrami that if I become mayor, I will make sure that it will open.
Uh-oh.
And now, on Monday, July 29,
yeah, that's a big day
now,
for you.
We will now open Waskrami Elementary School. 2 weeks ago, I visited PNP Chief Albayalde personally, and I relayed to him that the school will now open. There have been issues regarding the firing range, and he said, in fact, he promised, even in spite of all the rectification that has been done by the previous PNP chief to ensure that no bullets will actually come out and hit the school, he is adding even more precautionary measures.
Oh, but is the school ready? I mean,
yes.
Where did you get the money to actually have the school prepared for opening? I'm curious, you bought chairs. I mean, you had to buy a lot of things to get the school prepared.
Okay. The school was completed way back in 2015.
Uh-oh.
Okay, now
so
that,
may gamit na.
We're only talking about the physical structure.
Okay.
So now that we won as mayor, our DepEd San Juan, of course, has been very cooperative with us.
Uh-oh.
So the equipment.
So it's coming from the national government.
Yes, the chairs and equipment from
Pati
other
electric
schools.
Electric fans ba? May ano ba?
Yes, it's complete.
Complete na.
So all the equipment that were not used by the other San Juan public schools were transferred
Uh-oh.
Here.
Uh-oh. Okay.
And just to give you an idea.
Ano ba to? Grade 1 to grade?
This is an elementary school, so we're starting with kinder to grade 3.
Okay.
And now we will have a transition all the way up to the higher grades.
Uh-oh.
And we've already written all public schools in San Juan that have students from Barangay Waskrami, informing them that they can now transfer to Waskrami Elementary School.
So why do you think didn't Mayor Gia really continue that? Was it because it was seen as a Zamora project then? Because your father initiated it?
Yes, that's true. And just for you to have an idea, Barangay Waskrami is the biggest voting population in San Juan.
Okay, because what's interesting is now what will you do? When Mayor Aguia Gomez stepped down from office, she did express your support, asking for your support to continue the Emilio Jacinto National High School. That was her proposal because she says land has been expropriated already.
Okay.
So will you continue that?
Okay, just to make it clear, there's still no funding for that school. Okay. So
but would you be the type of mayor? Yun ang tanong ko, in a way, is okay. She didn't open my school. I would follow her proposal. Are you in that mode?
No. In fact, even without her telling me, I've already promised, even back in 2016 when I first ran as mayor, and again in 2019, I already promised that if I win, I will open a second high school.
Yeah.
Because currently, we only have one San Juan National High School.
And it's overpopulated.
Overpopulated. The classes are the whole day.
Yeah.
Simply because it cannot accommodate the volume of students. So the
you
second
really need
high
to
school,
open.
The second high school is something that I've really planned to open ever since 2016. And now that I've become mayor, we will indeed do this. She is saying that she wants me to continue. However, even if she does not say that, I'm already planning to do that. So,
but then you said earlier, yung land na yon, yung land that's been expropriated. You've seen that land?
Yes. There's a lot of government
land
that's available. So it's really up to us to decide where we will build the second high school. But I am not the type who will block any uncontinued or unfinished project simply because of politics. In fact, a lot of infrastructure were uncompleted by the previous administration. Just to give you an idea, the Justice Hall remains to be uncompleted.
Uh-oh.
So I will have to work with my father, Congressman Noni Zamora, to get national funding to complete this.
Uh-oh.
Second is our hospital. It's not yet complete.
Yeah. You'd have to open that complete.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.